student, standard 9, subject science 1. Last lecture, already we have started our lesson number 5, acids, bases and salts. And in that, already we have studied about the dissociation of ionic compounds and about the Arrhenius theory. Okay, today we are going to start here. Next point, classification of acids and bases. This classification is given according to the dissociation of the ionic compounds. And according to that, acids and bases are classified into the strong and the weak type. First, we will do the discussion about strong acid and the weak acid. Okay? Now, one flow chart I have drawn down side of it. See it carefully. Strong acid. Strong acid means what? The acid which on dissolving in water dissociates completely. Dissociates means to go in free state. What is the meaning of dissociation? To go in free state. So, strong acid on dissolving in water dissociates completely and aqueous solution contains mainly H plus ions. Mainly which ions are there? H plus ions and concerned acidic radicals. Concerned means related to that. Understanding to everyone? Strong acid means what? The acid which dissolving after in the water dissociate almost completely and aqueous solution contains mainly which ions? H plus ions and concerned acidic radicals. This is known as the strong acid. Now see the example. First example, which one I have written? HCl. HCl means hydrochloric acid. And HBr means hydrogen bromide. HCl and HBr, these two examples are of strong acid. Now let us see the weak acid. Weak acid means that is when acid dissolving in water dissociates incompletely. Means these acids does not go in free state completely. Dissociation occurs incompletely and aqueous solution contains small proportion of OH plus ions. What is the difference? See it carefully. Small proportion of H plus ions and the concerned acidic radical along with large proportion of undissociated molecules of acid. Now, if we see the difference in between the strong acid and weak acid, that small proportion of H plus ions and the concerned acidic radical, these are both present in the strong acid. But H plus, mainly which ions are present in the strong acid? Mainly H plus ions are present. But in weak acid, these H plus ions are present in small proportion with their concerned acidic radical. And along with the concerned acidic radical, it contains the large proportion of undissociated molecules. Why undissociated molecules is written here? Because weak acid dissociates incompletely. They do not go in a free state completely. So it dissociates incompletely. So some large proportion of undissociated molecules are present in the weak acid. So understanding to everyone, the difference in between the strong acid and weak acid. Now see the example. H2CO3 means carbonic acid and CH3COOH means acetic acid. These two are examples of the weak acid. Now in this chart only, we will see the strong base and the weak base means what. Okay, see here. like. I will write here strong base and here weak base. Okay, see. Now what is the difference here? Strong base dissociates completely and aqueous solution contains mainly in acid water than H plus ion. Instead of that, we will write here OH minus ions. Okay? The aqueous solution contains mainly OH minus ion and concern which radicals should be there. Instead of acidic, basic radicals are present in it. Okay? See here examples. Examples are KOH and NaOH. KOH means potassium hydroxide and NaOH means sodium hydroxide. So see it again one time. Strong base means on dissolving in water, if base dissociates completely and aqueous solution contains mainly which ions? Mainly OH minus ions and concern which radicals? Basic radicals, then this is known as the strong base. Examples are KOH and NaOH. Now the weak base. In weak base also same points are there, but what will be the difference? See, instead of H plus ions, what we have to write here? OH minus ions. OH minus ions. And the concern, instead of acidic, what we have to write here? Instead of acidic, basic radicals. Basic radical along with the large proportion of undissociated molecules of base. Okay, see it again one time. Weak base is what? In dissolving in water, when that dissociates incompletely, substance dissociates incompletely, that an aqueous solution contains in small proportion of which ions? OH minus ions. And the concerned basic radical along with the large proportion of undissociated molecules of the base. This is known as the weak base. Example is NH4OH means ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide is an example of weak base. So, understood to everyone, what is the difference between the strong acid, weak acid, strong base and the weak base? Now, let us see the next point. Alkali. Alkali means the bases which are highly soluble in water. Alkali is it means base only, but in that the bases which are highly soluble in water, these bases are known as the alkali. Here already example that when you have studied the strong base, at that time you have studied that potassium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide, these are the strong alkali. Okay, and NH3 is a weak alkali. So these are the example of strong bases also and alkalis also. Why this example of alkali? Because these both bases are highly soluble in water. So they are known as in a alkali group. Now see the next point. Concentration of acid and base. For that, first we will see one activity here and then I will explain about the concentration of acid and base. See the activity. For this activity, you have to take two beaker. Label upon it A and B. After that, you have to take one lemon. Cut it into two equal pieces. And have to squeeze into the A beaker and another one piece you have to squeeze into the B beaker. After that, in A beaker you have to take their water, but take only 10 ml water in that. Okay, and in B beaker take 20 ml water. Here lemon juice means it is known as the solute, and water is a solvent. Now what is the meaning of solute? The substance which dissolves in the solvent, it is known as the solute. Already in 8th standard you have studied about the solvent and the solution. Here water is a solvent. If you will see, the proportion of solute is same in both, okay, and the proportion of water is different. Now what change will be there in between these two solution? If you will take the taste from that A beaker, it will be the less so, and if you will take the solution in A beaker will be the more so as compared to the B beaker. Why? Because the proportion of the solute is higher in the A beaker, okay, and it is less in a B beaker. Okay, so from that activity we can understand, if we want to see the concentration of acid and base, see the meaning of it. All the properties of a solution depends on the nature of the solute. The properties of the solution depends upon the nature of the solute. Solute means here lemon we have to, and solvent, and also on the proportion of the solute in the solution. It depends upon the solute and solvent, and also on the proportion of the solute in the solution. Whatever solute is present in the solution depend upon that all properties of the solution are there. So this is about the concentration of acid and base. Now let us see the next point, the types of the solution. There are two types of solutions are present here: concentrated solution and dilute solution. Now concentration solution means concentration of solute is high. Now concentration means the proportion of the solute. Concentration means what? Proportion of the solute. If high there, then this type of solution is known as the concentrated solution. And dilute solution means concentration of solute is low. Concentration means proportion of the solute is low there, then this type of solution is known as the dilute solution. So understood the difference in between the concentrated and dilute solution. Concentrated means the proportion of solute is high, and dilute means the proportion of solute is low. Now units for the concentration of a solution, there are two units are given here. The first one is gram per liter. Gram per liter means the mass of the solute in gram present in 1 liter of the solution. So the unit for the concentration of a solution is, first unit which one is there? Gram per liter. And the another one unit is m. M means molarity. Okay, here mass of the solute which is dissolved in 1 liter of solution. So the which unit is used for the as a unit for the concentration of solution? M, molarity. And molarity is expressed by writing the molecular formula into the bracket. Here one example I have written. Which example I have written here? NaCl means sodium chloride, but I have written that in a bracket. It means the molarity of sodium chloride solution is 1 molar. And already you have studied the value of M is 1.622 into 10 raised to 23. This is the value of 1 molar. So, here two units which are used for the concentration of solutions are gram per liter and the molarity. Now, the next point is about the pH of solution. pH means power of hydrogen. What is the meaning of pH? Power, P means power, H means hydrogen. Power of hydrogen is known as the pH of solution. The proportion of H plus and OH minus ions is present in the different types of the natural aqueous solution. And these H plus and OH minus ions are present in the different proportion according to the solution present in the nature. Here in our blood cells have, there also H plus and OH minus ions are present in a proper proportion to carry out the functions of the body. If we want to find out the pH of the solution, there are different methods useful for it. Already in 8th standard you have studied there to find out the difference in between the acid and base. Litmus paper we can use for it. So just like for the pH of solution, the pH scale is used to measure the pH value of any solution there. And according to the strength of acid and base, that there are different types of value are given upon the pH scale. Okay? If pH is less than 7, then that solution is known as the acidic solution. If it is greater than 7, then it is known as the basic solution. And if it is 7, then it is known as the neutral solution. And according to the strength of the acid and base, for example, soil is divided into the 3 types: acidic, basic and the neutral soil. And how we can calculate it is present in a acidic, basic or the neutral type? By seeing the pH value of the soil. And pH value means what? The proportion of H plus and OH minus ions present in the solution. Okay? Now, universal indicator, just like a point I have written here, universal indicator, this is a one type of indicator which are useful to make that pH scale. And according to that pH scale, that 1 to 14 numbers you can see upon the pH scale. Different numbers are written here, and according to the number, different colors also you can see upon the pH scale. And by observing that pH scale, we can understand by observing the color of that solution. We can understand that solution is coming in acidic, neutral or the basic. This is the first one method is there, that by using pH scale we can find out the pH of the solution. But another one, that accurate method is there which is useful to find the pH of solution, that is meter scale. That one type of electrode is there. When we will dip into the solution, accurately we can find the pH of that solution by using that instrument. So here in this point we have studied about the pH of solution and how we can find the pH of solution by using the pH scale, and it is made by the universal indicators. Universal indicators means different. This universal indicator is made by mixing the different types of the synthetic indicators. Synthetic indicators means in that natural indicators also there. In that, if we will see, the phenolphthalein is there, methyl orange is there. So by mixing it, universal indicator is made, and it is useful to make the pH scale.